So my unit is titled The Pursuit of Happiness. Okay, I didn't really put... It's a unit on Into the Wild is the major text, and it intros with some stuff on transcendentalism. So a little bit of Thoreau, a little bit of Emerson, and kind of talking about the ideals of transcendentalism and how that's another way to pursue happiness, pursue the American dream, and then it goes into the Wild and kind of connects back to our first unit that was on the American dream. So, school context, it's a high school in South King County, it's Auburn Riverside. I didn't know if I was supposed to put the actual school information. 1,600 students, 55% white, 22% Hispanic, 11% Asian Pacific Islander, 10% Asian, 6% two or more races, 5% black and African American. And that kind of breakdown of ethnicity plays out fairly standardly in my classes. The school pulls from pretty diverse communities, so there's a lot of socioeconomic extremes. Pulls from kind of like the Lake Taps, Lakeland Hills area, and like Algona Pacific, and like the trailer parks by the river, and homeless kids, so there's a whole lot of diversity there. So you get kids in $1 million houses and kids sleeping in their cars, so I think that's really interesting to have all of that in the same classroom. 36% qualify for free or reduced lunch. So my classroom is 11th grade American Literature. I have this first and second period. They're 55-minute classes. First period is my biggest class with 28 students, 60% male, 40% female, which I thought was interesting because I feel like most classes are more female. And so there's one student with an IEP. In both my classes, there are a lot of students where it notes in their health information that they have ADD and ADHD, but there's no IEP, no accommodations or anything like that for them. Several students have emotional problems, vision problems, and hearing problems. So those two, just the vision and hearing affect where I see kids. Second period is 24 students, it's a 50-50 split. There's one student that's qualified as ELL, one medical 504, he gets extended time on his assignments. And again, kids with ADD, ADHD. And a lot of kids, I think, were ELL, a lot of kids that don't speak English at home, but that are no longer qualified as limited English proficiency. So I feel like I still need to kind of consider that. So for my introductory gateway activity lesson, my learning target would be I can reflect on the meaning of the pursuit of happiness in general, as well as how it relates to my own life specifically. So this particular learning target isn't aligned with a specific standard, but the whole unit is. So this introductory lesson will introduce the concept of the pursuit of happiness, and it'll activate students' prior knowledge that'll help them throughout the unit. And the reflective writing that they'll do helps them prepare for a personal narrative that they'll write as a needs assessment, and that relates to one of the writing standards for Common Core. So the assessments during the unit, they'll do daily exit tickets that will allow them to reflect on their understanding of the learning targets, and then this I'll use to kind of formatively assess and adjust my instruction. Unit goal one, which is I can argue whether or not transcendentalist values are still present in American society. And my second goal is I can evaluate the purpose and effect of an author's structural choices in a text. Both of these will be assessed by informal writing prompts and class discussions. And so this will again allow me to kind of assess where students are in their understanding. This requires that students have the ability to respond to writing prompts and participate in class discussions. These are skills they've acquired and been building throughout the year, so it's stuff they're already familiar with. The third goal is I can compose a personal narrative related to the theme of the pursuit of happiness and or transcendental values that employs intentional, structural, and stylistic techniques. So this is kind of the final summative assessment. And then the combination of informal and formal assessments will, again, allow me to assess students and see that they're making progress. So the personal narrative assessment, this is just kind of the skill that they need. This breakdown is taken out of my Springboard textbook. Choosing organizational structure, stylistic techniques, just kind of basic writing stuff. By the end of the unit, students should show progress on the skills required. They'll have a gain knowledge of the ways in which authors use structure and genre for effect. Because that's something we're going to focus on, especially with Into the Wild, is the way that structure is used, like the timing of plot, the sequencing of events, and then the genre, like pulling in letters and the, epitaphs? What are they, like the little quote at the beginning of the chapter? And then the chapter goes, my brain's fried. epigraph something?
Something like that.
Anyways. So, prior knowledge. Students have experience responding to writing prompts, participated in class discussions, they're familiar with the structure and expectations. I'm not sure yet if I'll do any, like, big formal, like, Socratic seminar-type class discussions, or if we'll just be kind of, like, discussing the reading as we go along. If I were to do, like, a big official whole class discussion, I would review the expectations, just because at least in the last like few months they haven't done a big discussion like that. So I would review like the expectations with respect and building up people's responses and all of that. But if it's just like day-to-day discussion, I won't. Students have written multi-paragraph essays, but this is the first personal narrative essay this year. And students are able to connect personal experiences to themes in literature. Students will learn how authors make intentional choices in structure for effect in the narrative, how authors use a variety of genres for effect. They will improve their skills of responding to writing prompts, participating in class discussions, and writing personal narrative essays. And they will learn the ideals of transcendentalism and how to identify these ideals in modern society. So my gateway activity. Students will come in, and the question on the board is, what is happiness to you, or what does happiness mean to you? So that'll just be like a quick little like jot down ideas of what they think that is, and then we'll kind of talk about that. And then, have you guys seen this? It's the 80 odd years of happy video. It's the happy song, but it's like these old people at our retirement home like dancing to it, and it's the cutest thing ever. and I figured Pharrell's happy is like a little overdone, but I thought this version was cute, so I would show that. And then briefly discuss the video and like how it portrays happiness. And then, so I would have kids read the unit overview that's in their spring board books, which just talks about happiness, and then have them jot down a few responses to a few questions and discuss it with their table group. So what does it mean to pursue happiness? Then how the Declaration of Independence states that people are given certain rights, including life, liberty, and the pursuit of happiness. Why do you think our founding fathers made the pursuit of happiness a right? And then, are people entitled to the pursuit of happiness at all costs? What happens when one person's happiness is in conflict with another person's or in conflict with the law? So they'll just discuss this with their groups. And then kind of my main introductory activity follows Smagransky's model of writing about personal experiences. So it'll help them relate their personal experiences to the knowledge and the text that they'll produce and read. And it'll also be a little bit of a prelude for their personal narrative essay, kind of get them thinking about that. So my reflective writing prompt is, think about what happiness means to you. Reflect on a time when you were pursuing happiness. What was that happiness, and what did you do to pursue it? Were you successful? Did the pursuit change your thoughts on happiness? So I'll have the rest of the class to write that, and then it'll be due at the beginning of class the next day, and it'll just be informal.
Not 9 minutes. Is there any feedback?
Hey, what about the rules for the video? Oh, do you guys want to see the video? Okay.
We like to see old people dance, do we not?
And, like, the main guy is, like, my favorite in the world.
I think the fact that you're reading the Constitution and having them reflect on that, that's awesome.
Yeah, I think that's interesting. I mean, it's not, we're not going to focus a lot on the Declaration of Independence, but I think it's an interesting,
just having that reference, yes, I think is really neat.
And then it can bring in, like, how they study that in history, what they know about it.
Yeah.
Good interdisciplinary.
Yeah.
It might seem crazy, but I'm about to say.